The second case study leads us to Vienna. Here we find an intra-urban transformation from a commercial area. You can see here. To housing. So this is a branch of Danube River, and this goes right through the city center. This is a quite central place that is subject to transformation. And the third example also is in Vienna. We are talking of a new development on an abandoned railway station site. There is a new master plan, and what we do there is inserting one housing project. So, when we look at the three different sites, what do we find? On the first one in Innsbruck, which is very evident, is the lacking of infrastructure, insufficient cultural life. You probably know this kind of social housing estates on the suburbs of almost every European city. So it's very similar probably in, here in Milan as well. And the problem with these estates is that we have spaces between the huge blocks which do have a large scale, but they don't have any spaciousness. So that's what we find is a big problem, and one of the problems why these areas don't work really good. So the second case study, the problem there was the access to the river. An insufficient road and path system. You see that this kind of business area works as a barrier. So you don't have any access to the water. And you have a through traffic along this waterfront, which is also a problem for future developments. And on the other hand, we have this railway station area in the very center of Vienna. The topic on this side was intercultural living. I think this is a topic which may concern not only Vienna, this is a topic which concerns many European cities. How can we live together with immigrants? And in this connection, we are discussing the theme of living in this urban context, and what do you do with the ground floor? So this is a problem where we were thinking about. So this is kind of solutions that we proposed, but now we would like to go into these three projects. First of all, I'm talking of Zentrum Odorf, which some of you may know, as we heard. What we find there, as I told you before, is in this area, you have these blocks from the 60s and 70s. You have huge spaces here in between, but you don't have a single place where people can meet. And when we started with this project, we really tried to find access to that area, which is on the first sight not very charming. And So we tried to find out what is this all about. What can we find there? And this is some pictures that I just want to show to give you an imagination of the things we were dealing with. Here is, for example, see one of these spaces in between. It's green, so you could say everything's all right. You have big scale blocks, so but what can you do in between? On the other hand, in this, when you look closer, you find a poetic quality in this kind of suburban area. Somehow it's a very unsentimental and strangely foreign place, I found at least. And in the end, I was really excited about the idea to somehow interact with this surrounding, with this scale. And well, these are some more pictures of the neighborhood. And well, coming to the point, what was our urban intention? We thought a building should generate a public square. That's what we did. And a public square is supposed to generate public life in the quarter. So what we did, we implemented a building which deals with the scale of the existing ones, but by forming its L shape, kind of defines a public square. And when we look at the public spaces that we created, we find a central public space in midst of the surrounding. So this is the L-shaped building. We did the landscape design together with a landscape architect in Venice. This part was not realized. This is a playground, and this little wood realize this one as well. So the building is this plan shows public spaces on the ground floor. Of course, this is what you see here. This is the public square. We have a multi-purpose hall here on the edge. We have a supermarket in this long branch of the L-shaped building. And we have all the entrances to the various uses of the buildings on the square. So all the people that use this building, approximately 700 people a day, they all have to cross the square. They all have their entrances on from the square, and this produces many paths across the square and activity. Some elements of the square. We have what was crucial for the project and for us, this distinctive L shape had to be broken up in the edge, and we tried to make it visual permanent. So the red lines you can see are the side lines through the building. And that creates a pattern that we, in the end, painted on the black asphalt square. There is another element, the so-called pergola. So this is a transformation. location of a cloud, in particular it's a cloud from the Sahara zone. It's a picture I found. And we translated this picture into sun blinds